Vienna. Vienna. Tell me about yourself. Living in Vienna, Turhan Bey. What a life.
Yes, a life like every place else.
No, not like every place else. Is that where you've been living all these years in Vienna?
Yes, yes.
Where are you actually from?
I was born in Vienna.
You were?
Skip, yes. My father was Turkish, my mother was Viennese.
Uh-huh. But you came to Hollywood, and you studied acting here.
At Ben Bard's Dramatic School.
Ben?
Wilshire and Fairfax, or was it Wilshire and LeBray? I don't remember.
Uh-huh.
Ben Bard, wonderful teacher.
And you got right into the films immediately.
Yes, about 4 months after I enrolled there, we did a play. Ben Bard needed a very weird character for one of his plays, and I was the only weird character around there.
Uh-huh.
So he asked me to play this part, and I loved it. They put gray in my hair. I was 17 at that time.
Mm-hmm.
Put gray in my hair and made me look a little older, and we did this show, was called A Third Eye, a mystical kind of a drama, which was very successful. And then, I think, after the third night, I got a call from Warner Brothers. They said, we would like to have you for a picture.
And what was that?
That was Errol Flynn and Brenda Marshall in Footsteps in the Dark.
Ooh.
It was wonderful, wonderful.
That Errol Flynn, my God.
Yes, yes.
Brenda Marshall.
He was very good.
Tell me about Errol Flynn, working with Errol Flynn. He was... At that time, do you remember?
He was one of the biggest stars, if not the biggest one here.
At the moment,
At the moment, yes. And he remained so after many years after.
Right.
And he was charming and very helpful to me. I was a little nervous, not too nervous, but if somebody would have not been a little encouraging to me, it would have been very difficult. But it wasn't. He made it very nice. And Alan Hale was also wonderful, wonderful.
And Brenda Marshall?
I never worked
your
with
scenes?
Her. My scenes were not with her.
Oh, I see.
No, but with Alan Jenkins.
Uh-huh. Hollywood must have been great in those days, in the 40s.
Oh, Turhan. It was. Yes,
looking
it was.
Down, I mean, thinking the Hollywood car, the red car in Hollywood Boulevard, going from Los Angeles down to Santa Monica in this red car. And it was like a farm. People were friendly, weren't they?
Well, they're friendly now.
Oh, come on, Turhan. Have you been to Hollywood Boulevard today?
I love Hollywood Boulevard. I go there almost every day.
Since you've been back?
You know, it's a very strange thing. I did go very rarely when I was acting here.
Right.
But now Hollywood Boulevard, to me, is the liveliest part of Hollywood. When I go on the Rodeo Drive, Camden Drives, which I used to love, I still do, but it's like a museum. You know, everything is very formal, everything is very strict. The leisureness that has disappeared, and that's what I loved about California, that's what I loved about Los Angeles.
You did a wonderful movie with Susanna Foster called Climax.
Yes.
You did
yes.
several with her, matter of fact.
Yes, I think three or four pictures we did together.
One of my favorite ladies, Susanna Foster.
Yes, what a wonderful woman.
Singer.
One of the best.
Did you see her since you've been back? Have you seen her?
Yes, I visited her the other day. Found her very charming. She's a Sagittarian, if astrology means anything to you or to you. I don't know how many of our listeners
They all love astrology in America.
In one way or another.
Jacqueline Stallone helped with that.
Of course. She's one of the greatest.
You're right.
I had the pleasure of dining with her the other day. And Susie Foster, being a Sagittarius, is in great shape, always willing to fight whatever adverse situations fate may present to her. Looking wonderful.
What is the day like for you living in Vienna? What is Turhan Bey's day like in Vienna? Now, I mean, you're not doing films. I mean, you're coming back here, you're doing some films, but living back there all these years, what is Turhan's day like?
Well, it's very easy to describe. I got up very early at 5 o'clock. I take a cold rub down, and without drying myself, I go back to bed. In half an hour, I'm dried up. This is an old German method of keeping young.
So you keep
yourself healthy.
You put water all over your cold water? Oh,
cold water all over so the pores close down, and then in the bed, when you're nice and well covered up, in half an hour you're dry again. Of course, I must say, Skip, this you can only do when you live alone. I don't think you could find a partner who would put up with that.
But you lived with your mother for many years.
Yes, for many years. All my life.
All your life?
Until she died, yes.
Until she died. Now you live alone.
Now I live alone.
In Vienna. Must be lovely.
Yes.
So what is it? So you do your cold shower, and then what happens?
And then I go back to sleep, and then when I wake up, I start polishing one camera, and then after 10 minutes I have breakfast, and I start polishing another camera, mm-hmm. and then very soon when the sun comes up or the days start,
right.
that I go shooting, either to the Vienna woods or into the city, or I have one of my many charming young ladies who come to the studio and I shoot some pictures of her.
You've been doing shooting pictures for many years. That's your love. Your first love?
Long before I became an actor, yes.
Before?
Before, yes, yes. That was always my great passion, photography.
Photography.
Yes.
And you used your name, Turhan Bey. How come you used your name as actor, photographer, Turhan Bey?
It was a mistake. One shouldn't do that. One should be a completely different personality as an actor and as a photographer.
Mm-hmm.
But I wasn't that wise at that time. And after a while, I stopped selling my pictures.
Who's some of the people have you done, Turhan, some famous people you have shot in your
famous
times,
people? Professionally, only professional models.
Models.
Yes, only professional models. I've shot pictures of all my friends, of course, but I've never used them commercially.
Did you work for some magazine company? What was it?
I worked for Globe.
Globe.
Globe Photos.
Right.
In New York. They were very good and sold many of my pictures.
But acting, theater, did you enjoy it?
Theater is very enjoyable. However, I dare say that I was never very successful at it, neither in New York nor in Europe, where I also played on the stage.
In the stage.
I think it's quite a different technique.
Uh-huh.
And I don't think I was very good at it. First of all, I was what Laurence Olivier, the great Olivier,
right.
called a giggler.
Uh-huh.
A giggler is a man who at the drop of a chapeau uh-huh. starts to laugh
uh-huh.
at anything that goes on. It's a kind of a nervousness.
Uh-huh.
And I suffered from that terribly, and I still would today.
Mm-hmm.
If anything funny would happen on a stage, I would immediately start laughing at places where I'm supposed to be quite serious.
Turhan, I watched a movie of yours just recent.
Yes?
I've seen several.
Well, you're working overtime.
But this particular movie was called Dragon Seed.
Ah, yes.
This movie was so wonderful. It was just on the classic films just recently, 2 weeks ago.
Oh, yes.
And
yes.
I heard you were in town. I said, I have to get you. I have to show a clip from this movie.
Ah.
It is a wonderful movie with you and Katharine Hepburn.
Yes, indeed.
And what a great cast in this movie.
Because
I'd like to show the clip from this movie and show the cast, too, of the film.
That is the Skip Lowe direction.
let's see it. Turhan Bey and Dragon Seed.
These are not ancient times.
Oh, I wish it were those times. I would like to lock you up.
If you lock me up, I would not eat, and then I should die.
Oh, I would not let you.
But these are the new times, and I will come and go as I please.
I should beat you.
I have done nothing.
But you are not what a woman should be at... at home, waiting for her husband.
Before we were wed, when the choice was put to you, why did you not choose me above my fourth cousin? If you could choose now, which would it be?
You both have two arms and two legs and all your fingers and toes, and you are neither of you scabby-headed nor cross-eyed. What then is the difference between you?
Oh, you use me very ill.
You look so pale and so thin. You are so to be pitied, you big turnip.
I wish I were a man of learning. I wish I knew the words to ease myself so I could tell you what I feel.
What do you feel?
I know, but I do not have the words.
I too am not very learned.
Is that why you do not often speak to me?
Two must speak for understanding.
If I tell you everything that is in me, will you tell me all that is in you?
Yes.
Then tonight we will speak together.
Yes.
Good. Turhan, Katharine Hepburn, one yes. of the greatest ladies in the film, stage, and a great lady.
Indeed, yes.
Working with her.
Was an experience, yes.
Share us just a little experience working with her. Because you were at contract at Universal at the
yes.
time, and they loaned you out to MGM?
Yes.
Tell me about working with Katharine Hepburn in Dragon Seed.
Superlatives, only superlatives of camaraderie, of helpfulness, of kindness, of a certain kind of criticism. I will never forget after we played one of these
scenes,
uh-huh. Katharine said, "Turhan, you're a very good actor, but you don't listen." And I said, "Wait a minute, what does she mean?" She didn't say any more. And then it suddenly occurred to me that while I was supposed to listen to what she said. I was just waiting for my cue.
Right.
There was no expression on my face.
No reaction.
There was no reaction in my eyes. Mm-hmm. And from then on, from all the future times on, I always remembered what Katharine told me.
Stuck in your mind.
It stuck in my mind, and she was so right.
You got to listen to the actor, what they're saying, and you react.
And not only that, but when you speak, the thought has to be first. The thought has to be in your eyes, and then the words follow.
Uh-huh.
And many actors, today I see them too, the word is simultaneous with the thought. That doesn't happen to people. People think first, and then they interpret, and then the word comes.
Right.
And the great actors, if you observe them, I was talking to your lady friend out there about Klaus Maria Brandauer, mm-hmm. who is the Austrian actor.
Right.
He is the perfect example of that today,
right.
which Laurence Olivier, what is his time, that the thought comes first, and
right.
then the word. Mm-hmm. And in my own modest way, I try also to do that.
How many films has Turhan Bey have done? You've done so many.
This is like
1944, this Dragon Seed. Is that correct? 1944?
That must have been
about,
yes, yes.
Oh, God.
Yes.
That
yes.
was such a great movie. God.
It was a wonderful movie, and we all enjoyed doing it, of course.
Uh-huh. How do you feel when you see yourself today?
Well, when I saw myself today, I said, first of all, I have to get myself that hat again from MGM. You know, we wouldn't have any problems with the highlights and with those things.
Uh-huh.
But I think I couldn't possibly wear
what
that.
What do you think of Hollywood today, Turhan?
I love it. I love it. You know, it's terrible. If I would ever write anything, I would sound like Pollyanna. But Hollywood, to me, is wonderful. It's just very different from the days before. The days that we were talking about, there were idols. Errol Flynn, Clark Gable, Gary Cooper. Innumerable. People wanted to have somebody to look up to.
Right.
To want to be like. Today, it has become much more realistic.
They want to look up to Madonnas. That's what they want to do.
Yes, well, and some of the girls, I'm sure, are imitating this very talented lady and want to be like. But she's not a woman, not a person that people would say physically, I could never be like that.
Right.
How many people could say physically they would be like Lana Turner,
right.
or like Betty Grable,
right.
or like Marilyn Monroe, in other words, or like Errol Flynn, Clark Gable? People would say, well, this I could never be. And then people came who taught us that you don't have to be beautiful and a half god, you have to have personality.
That's it.
There was a Bogart, there was a Sinatra, who were fascinating personalities, but they were not necessarily beautiful.
Yes.
And it taught us uh-huh. it's the personality,
the id
that can fascinate people uh-huh. just as much as beauty.
See, today, The beauty. That is all they think of. The beauty. There is no character, no individuality. That you're absolutely right. I agree with you very much there. And that's the lacking of what Hollywood is doing today. It is so...
I love those pictures.
Tell me those ladies that Turhan Bey went out with, like Lana Turner and all these great stars.
Well, I dated many of these charming, wonderful, patient ladies.
Uh-huh.
And, of course, at that time, as it is now, the columnists had to have their space, and many of the ladies who wept on my shoulders and told me about their husbands, about their boyfriends, the troubles they had with them, were never romantically involved with me, but I was a good listener, and first of all, I really cared. You know, to me, a woman in Hollywood, a beautiful woman in Hollywood, had one of the most difficult lives that you could possibly imagine, because she never knew what people wanted from her.
Really?
And the men, when it wasn't quite unlikely with the men too. You had many people who called you, who said they were your friends, but you were never sure if they really were. And you only found out, and this was the most interesting part of my career, when my career started to go downward.
Right.
There I really found out who my friends were, that stuck with me, that were still my friends. Uh-huh. The other ones drifted off. They had other things to do. They had to find people who were going up the ladder.
They love to build people up, and then they let the tear them down. Why is that? Well, they love to build them up and
tear them down. You have something, an interesting point that I don't want to be true necessarily, but it is true.
It is.
There is a certain kind of maybe envy or frustration in people who are part of the industry, but not the beautiful part of it, which is acting or singing.
Right.
And some of these people are being mistreated by the stars. I must say, I was sometimes very thoughtless myself towards some of these
people. You were?
Yes, I was. I never forget the only time my name was mentioned in Life magazine.
Right.
Was when there was a little boy who was somehow impeded. I think he had a bad leg, and he had a camera, and everybody loved him. He had a little camera and shot pictures of the people.
Right.
And at one time he was standing in line, and I was going with one of the very beautiful ladies, and he popped up in front of us and he shot right into this girl's face.
Right.
And the bulb broke. They didn't have strobes at that time, and hit her in the eye.
Hit her in the eye.
And for some reason or other, maybe understandably, I was not very kind to this boy.
I see.
But it was my luck that this boy was interviewed in Life magazine, because he was a very well-known personality.
I see.
And the only time when my name appeared in Life was together with Greer Garson, and this boy was interviewed and said, "Who are the people that you dislike most, who were most unkind to you?" And he said, "The people that I were most unkind to me was Greer Knock-Kneed Garson and Turhan Vomit Face Bay."
Oh.
My claim to fame in Life magazine.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. Well, you seem very spiritual, Turhan. You seem very spiritual. Are you?
Well, I don't know what you mean on the spiritual. If you believe that if I believe in things that are...
You believe you care for others.
Oh, yes. Oh, absolutely.
That's what
absolutely.
I mean. That's
absolutely
what spiritual really means to me.
Yes.
Being
yes,
kind. Yes. Kindness is the greatest force in the world, to be kind to
someone. I agree with you, and that's why we understand each other so well.
I think so. Yes. I try to live that way.
Yes, and the way you treat your people in the interviews.
Exactly.
I saw one the other day. It is wonderful, because you're trying to find the positive side, and with the positive side you uncover some negative things too, which we all have. I'm sure you do as well as I have.
So living in Hollywood now, you're not living. You're just passing through, but you're here for a film.
The kindness of David Guest, the wonderful producer of the Cinema Awards, who's invited me 3 times now already.
Right.
So I came this time again for 2 weeks, and I stayed for three. I'm going to stay for 3 months.
You are?
Oh, yes. I love it. Really got under my skin.
You got yourself an agent now, and you're going to get out there get some work. And
hopefully so. But
you
in 3 months,
you
come.
You know, Turhan, you got to battle with these young casting agents out there, young little girls.
Yes, yes.
They don't know Turhan Bey or Shelley Winters sometimes. Shelley had to bring her Oscar to say, "What have you done?" She says, "I've done this."
Yes,
now, you tell me about yourself.
I have no Oscar. I'm sorry. I don't even have a picture of myself. I've never kept a picture of myself. terrible. I was really very negligent in that respect.
You know, your picture, autograph picture, is worth $35.
Yes.
We found out.
Our friend
$35.
Yes, yes.
That's what I was found out.
And that's above many of my colleagues who have worked here very hard all these years.
So what have you been doing? You had the theaters in Vienna all these years? Tell me about that.
Well, they were a chain of motion picture theaters, some of which I sold, and some of the ones that are left, two to be exact, I've rented or leased.
Uh-huh.
And I have nothing to do with them anymore. I don't program them anymore. I don't, I just let people take care of them.
Do you watch a lot of movies today?
I do, but only at home on the television.
On television.
On the television. I very rarely go to the movies. I must shamefully, I admit, I wait until they come to television, then I record them and look at them as I feel like. Some comedies and some tragedies. Mm-hmm. That's what I do.
Is Turhan Bey writing?
Writing?
Mm.
I've written about 30 letters in all my life.
Oh, come on. Writing a book.
No.
Your experiences, your life, your mirror.
It would sound like Pollyanna going through Hollywood. You know, I've never had a bad experience here, or I must say any other place, where if I gave it a little thought, I couldn't immediately detect my own doings in it, you know. You believe in the same things.
Right.
Everything that happens to us, good or bad, stems from within us. And if you think the right way and you live the right way, you're unable to think negatively.
So looking back, Turhan Bey,
yes.
Do you have any regrets? Would you do it the same way?
Not everything, I'm surely not. I certainly would act more professional than I did before.
What do you mean more professional? Tell me, what do you mean by that?
Maybe my career started on a very easy way, in a very easy way. Everything came easy to me. I was at Ben Bartz for 6 months, then I went into pictures, then I was signed to a contract, then these wonderful girls wrote in when I played heavies that I shouldn't die in every picture, that I should get the girl, then I became a leading man. Maybe it was too easy for me, and I didn't know what work was behind making a picture. And my dear friend Tyrone Power once told me, he said, Turhan, also, he said, you're a very good actor, but you're not a professional, because I was late on the set.
You were late?
Oh, yes.
Really?
Yes, I often was late, and that cost the studios thousands and thousands of dollars.
Why were you so late, Turhan? What made Turhan Bey late on the set?
Nightlife.
Drinking?
No, just going out? Just coming in at 3 o'clock in the morning and having to get up again at 5.
Really?
There wasn't enough sleep for a young fellow, you know. And then it wasn't, I mean, I was an hour late sometimes. An hour late is for
a
studio a lot of money. Mm-hmm. And professionals never do that.
Favorite film? You have one?
Mummy's Tomb.
Mummy's Tomb.
Yes,
that's right. You did Mummy's Tomb.
Wonderful, wonderful picture.
Who was in that?
Lon Chaney. George Zucco, the wonderful English actor, and of course Elise Knox, a dream girl of all dream girls, and the contract to Universal at that time, married to Paul Hesse, a dear friend of mine.
What makes that your favorite film?
Well, I love to play heavies with a cause. That are not heavies because they are mean, but they are part of a movement, they are part of a way of life that makes them act contrary to what good people do. Uh-huh. And that was, in this case, the young priest who was ordained to return this mummy to Egypt, where it belonged to.
Uh-huh.
And to me, that was a wonderful part. I don't know how, I don't think I ever saw the picture completed, but I remember loving to play that part.
Favorite director? Do you have one?
Favorite director, I think, this is very difficult to say because each director in his own way was splendid. I've never worked with anybody whom I didn't feel
at ease with
or that wasn't sympathetic.
There are a lot of unsympathetic directors here in Hollywood. They don't mean to be because they want to get done.
Well, with some people you have to be rough.
Yes.
With some people you cannot. My dear friend Paul Hesse was the kindness itself. But with some of the models that he worked, I saw him being very rough. And he said, Turhan, I've got to do it. I don't get any reaction from them any other. The most incredible director I worked with, whom I appreciate now more than it was Raoul Walsh at Warner Brothers. Right. I played a small part in a picture with Peter Lorre, and I think it was Humphrey Bogart. Mm. And Raoul Walsh was a man whom you never felt. He told you, you go here and you go there, and then he watched from a distance. And I said, well, did I do well? Did I do badly? I never knew. Uh-huh. But when I see his pictures now, I see how far advanced he was. He was a man who expected from his actors not anything more than the script asked for.
Yes.
And he never made them do any more. This was great. I never realized it until much later when I saw his other films, not the ones that I played in.
Ladies. Some of your ladies in the films.
Ladies in the
Who's
films.
Who's some of the ladies that you really enjoyed being?
Above all, our initial partner, Catherine Hepburn.
Most
amazing person I've ever met. The most intelligent, quick-minded. To me, this was the American blue-blooded woman, you know,
yes.
Who is helpful to everybody, but who will not take anything from anybody, who will not be stepped on by anybody.
To be a good actor, got to be intelligent. Is that correct? I think intelligence is the most important to be a good actor.
Yes.
What do you think?
I don't know all actors.
I think,
but
to be.
I would agree with you. However, in many muses, there are talents that are just natural that have nothing to do with intelligence or kindness. You know, there are geniuses in music, in acting, who were anything else but kind and good. And I think intelligence is synonymous with goodness and kindness.
Goodness and kindness, of course.
Not necessarily with talent.
Yes.
This I would have to think about, and I would have to know a lot more people than I do now.
Does Turhan Bey travel a lot now?
Not anymore. No, I try to stay at home as much as possible. I've done so much traveling in my life, moving from one place to another. You know, my father was a diplomat, and we were all constantly traveling from one place
to another. That's right. Your father was a diplomat,
yes.
Traveling all over the world.
All over the world, yes. And then later on, we were traveling in Europe.
Uh-huh.
And then in America, so I'm only 69,
you look wonderful.
Well, thanks.
Do you come to America often, Turhan? You were
I
here.
I have been here now 3 times in succession through the courtesy of the Cinema Awards.
Uh-huh. You enjoyed that, did you?
I enjoy that very much.
You must have seen a lot of your old friends.
Oh my God, Virginia Mayo, I saw whom I loved. I did Out of the Blue with it at Eagle Lion. It was still a beautiful. Beautiful, wonderful lady, and I saw many of the ones who are still alive. Many of them, unfortunately, are not there.
And your friend Paul Hendry. Tell me about
Paul. My dear friend Paul Hendry.
Wonderful.
Oh, well, he's still a beautiful man.
Is he?
And and witty and charming and what I never knew, which was amazing to me. He was, you know, a monarchist of the first degree. He is from one of the oldest aristocratic Viennese families.
Is he?
And he was banned here for years because they suspected him to be a communist.